I may have an idea here. I'm just thinking out loud now. That seems to me that it's up to us to convince this gentleman that we're right and he's wrong. Maybe if we each took a minute or two, you know, try it on for size. Okay, let's start it off.
Oh, well, I just think he's guilty. I mean, I thought it was obvious. Well, no one proved otherwise.
Nobody has to prove otherwise. The burden of proof is on the prosecution. The defendant doesn't even have to open his mouth. That's in the Constitution, the Fifth Amendment. You've heard of it.
Well, sure, I've heard of it. I know what it is. Well, what I meant was, I just think he's guilty.
Okay, let's get to the facts. Number one, let's take the old man who lived on the second floor right underneath the room where the murder took place. At 10 minutes after 12, on the night of the killing, he said he heard loud noises in the upstairs apartment. He said it sounded like a fight. Then he heard the kid say to his father, "I'm going to kill you." A second later, he heard a body falling and he ran to the door of his apartment, looked out, and saw the kid running down the stairs and out of the house. Then they called the police and they found his father with a knife in his chest.
Look, what about the woman across the street? If her testimony doesn't prove it, nothing does. His window is right across from hers, across the L tracks, and she swore she saw him do it.
Through the windows of a passing elevated train?